invite the next speaker, Dr. Anjani Khanna. Dr. Anjani Khanna is going to deliver her talk on ophthalmic practice slowdown due to COVID. Dr. Anjani, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You can please start.
Screen visible?
Yeah, it is. Please. You can start the slide share.
Good afternoon, everyone. And I, at the outset, I would like to thank the organizers and Professor Bhalla for giving me this opportunity. So till now, we have seen the healthcare problems, the psychological problems, and the and even the microbiological aspects of COVID being covered so well. Now we'll see what is the economic impact of COVID on us as an ophthalmic community. So COVID wreaked in havoc. It caused widespread deaths, healthcare issues. We saw nationwide and statewide lockdowns, and Indian economy hit a low. We recorded the lowest GDP of 7.3% since independence. And definitely we as an ophthalmic community also suffered. There was a genuine fear in patients of stepping out of the house of the risk of contracting infection. There was a genuine fear in ophthalmologists of the risk of contracting infection. In fact, there was a study in which 72.5% of ophthalmologists didn't see patients during the first lockdown. Even if they wanted to, there was an inability of staff to travel and reach the clinics and hospitals. So a lot of us got infected, a lot of staff members got infected. So there was a lot of loss of working hours in ophthalmic practice. So all of this was going on, there was hardly any work coming in, but the fixed expenses as rentals and electricity had to go out. There was also added costs of the protective measures that we have to take now, PPEs and everything. So there was a lot of reduced paying capacity of hospitals and clinics. So this led to quite an imbalance of expenses and income. So so according to the study, there were 72.5% people who were not seeing any patients. And actually 1/3 of ophthalmologists were suffering from some kind of depression also during the lockdown. But every challenge and every adversity contains within it the seeds of opportunity and growth. So what we as a community and institution did was take a step back, take stock of things, and see where we could cut down the costs. So what we did and what can be done in future is to actually speak to the suppliers of consumables regarding better rates of things, of pharmaceutical and other consumables, renegotiation of credit periods, asking for delayed payments or staggered payments. The calibration of salaries was done. So in our institution, none of the staff were laid off. But what was done that the people who had salaries of less than 50,000, their salaries were not cut, and that brunt was borne by the people who earned more. It was kind of divided and proportionally divided amongst the staff and the doctors. Fixed costs and maintenance, the renegotiation was done for the rent rates, and the discretionary spends like on marketing and all were absolutely cut down. So the focus was on daily, weekly, and monthly cash flow. So what happened was people were not purchasing equipment. So we got equipment at a reduced cost. The rentals were reduced. So we were actually able to open 3 branches and actually lead to expansion during this COVID pandemic. Teleconsultations were done by most of the ophthalmologists all over India, which helps us touch base with the patients to reassure them. And abiding by the regulations of telemedicine, we can at least help the patients as much as we can. Training of staff was done. So what was important that the staff were not laid off, but since they had less work, for example, elective surgeries were not happening. So the OT staff were idle. So so instead of sitting idle, they were retrained for counseling or marketing so that if any staff is down, the other staff can take their position. So staff should be made multifunctional. There were huddle meets with staff and doctors to keep each other's morales up, psychologically supporting each other. There's been an epidemic of webinars during this of doctors and also with patients to spread awareness, allay their fears, especially with the mucor epidemic rising up and reassuring them. So what happened was the patients were not coming to clinics. They were actually sitting at home. They were actually not getting treated. So what most of the ophthalmologists saw was when the unlock happened, there was a patient surge. All of the pending cataract surgery cases turned into hypermature cataracts. Most of them turned into hypermature cataracts, and they all came back as with the other surgeries like intravitreal injections, etc. There was also a high rise of refractive errors due to screen use. Parents were very, very concerned about their kids using screens, and they came back for getting the refractive errors checked. COVID itself led to a lot of conjunctivitis and accommodation deficiency. There was also a mental makeup that, you know, we don't know when the third wave is going to hit. So during this unlock, a lot of patients came to get their glasses checked because they don't know when another lockdown is going to happen. Mucormycosis came as a very unfortunate epidemic. A lot of cases were seen, but many more were just scared. Even the patients who did not have COVID came rushing to the OPDs to ask if they were infected with black fungus. So we as an institution, we lost work about 60 to 80% during the lockdown, the first and the second. But when it opened, we gained work and it was 140% back. So the net was a loss of 20 to 30% of work, which is under the range of predictability. So what I want to say is that though there was a loss of work, strained finances, risk of contraction of infection, emotional losses, but we are a resilient race. So the lesson learned and how to prepare for the third wave is not to take things for granted, do cost cutting wherever possible, make the staff agile and multifunctional so that when one staff is down, the others can take their place and we can keep the show running. This is the time to psychologically, technically, and operationally update ourselves. So this is the time to for training and regrouping.
Yeah.
And tough times don't last, but tough people do. So when troughs like this come, what we can do is take a seat back, adjust gears, and prepare and sow seeds so that when things come back to normalcy, we can bounce right back up.
Thank you. Thank you, Anjani. I would invite a discussant for this talk, Dr. Amit Shah, sir. Are you there?
Yes, I am right there.
Yeah. Dr. Amit Shah, yes, we all know that ophthalmic practice has been adversely affected, like all other medical practices in COVID-19 and lockdown. So how do you think, how difficult it is to maintain the setup and pay salaries to all the employees with lesser income, sir?
It is going to be very difficult. It was very difficult since last 1.5 years, you know, to pay the salary, etc. And, you know, we have to include the cost of masks and sanitizers and PPE kit, etc. But we have to continue with the same just because, you know, patients are also suffering by the same COVID thing. And they cannot also give the proper payment also. So we have to accommodate in any way. Usually, you know, we have a high volume center in Ahmedabad. We are operating nearly 450 to 500 patients in a month. It has been reduced to now 200 to 250 patients only. But we have to wait and watch. We can't do everything. I had my 9 centers all over the India. I had to close my 2 centers. I can't help it just because of salary and all kind of those things.
And what do you think is a better strategy, sir? Is better to lay off the employees or retain the employees with reduced salary? I know it's a difficult question, but what is a better strategy?
With the reduced salary, we have to continue the whole thing. We have to run the show.
I think very, very well said, sir. Very well.